Hi friends, I'm Biolin. Welcome to mytechbits.com, a collection of my technical bits and pieces of information, online tools, calculators, and converters. You are now watching mytechbit.com's video session. In this session, I'll brief you about the differences between DBMS and RDBMS. I'll start with an overview of DBMS and RDBMS and then list down the major differences between them. To start with, let us see about DBMS. DBMS is an abbreviation which stands for Database Management System. DBMS was introduced during 1960s by several companies. Then it was standardized by Charles Beckman along with CODASL, a committee on data systems languages. It's a management system used for controlling the databases in the computers or disk or on a network. The model introduced by CODASL was called as network model. During the same period, IBM introduced its own DBMS, which followed the navigation model. Both these models have not considered relationship between tables. So fetching data from the database was time consuming. Also, data redundancy was very common. There are several components in DBMS like external interface, database language engine, query optimizer, database engine, DBMS management component. The external interface is nothing but a user interface which was used to communicate with the management component and the database. The database language engine is the component which interprets the query language and do the necessary actions supplied by the query language. The query optimizer component is used to optimize the supplied query language and identify the best plan for executing the query to fetch the result as fast as it could. The database engine is used to create or manipulate the data in the database objects like the table. The management component was used for taking database backups, performance monitoring, security management, etc. Now we will see the various types of DBMS. There are several types of DBMS, including the RDBMS. Of course, RDBMS is a subset of DBMS with a relationship between tables and rows. During the introduction, the navigation model was followed. During the 1970s, the Relational Database Management System, in short, the RDBMS, came into existence. We'll see about the RDBMS in detail later in this session. Then came the ORDBMS, that is the Object-Oriented Database Management System, followed by the ORDBMS, or the Object Relational Database Management System. Even before RDBMS, there was hierarchical DBMS. It follows a hierarchical model which is based on the tree-like structure of records. That is, one record could have only one parent. The parent record can have one or many child records. The network model was also introduced before RDBMS. It follows the concept of many-to-many relationship like a network. Unlike the hierarchical model, in network model, one record can have many parent and many child. Now let's briefly go over RDBMS. The abbreviation RDBMS stands for Relational Database Management System. It was introduced during the 1970s. As I mentioned earlier, RDBMS follows the relationship database model in which the data is stored in multiple tables. The tables are related to each other using primary keys and foreign keys. The relation model follows the database normalization techniques to avoid redundancy in the tables. The normalization technique helps the SQL queries to fetch the data from the tables faster than DBMS. RDBMS is currently the largest database model. It is widely used by the enterprises and the developers for storing complex and large amount of data. Now let us see how the tables and records are related in RDBMS model. If you see this table relationship diagram, the user ID in the users table is considered as the primary key. This primary key is used by the other tables like user relationships, user roles, user relationship preferences, and user profile as foreign key column. Because of this primary key and foreign key relationship, one record in users table can be linked to many records in the other tables. This is a simple representation of relationship between tables. With this, we have come to the final part of this session. Now, I will summarize everything I have talked so far as a table of differences between DBMS and RDBMS. To start with, DBMS was introduced during the 1960s and RDBMS during the 1970s. DBMS initially followed the navigation model of data storage, then evolved as a network model and hierarchical model. RDBMS followed the relationship between tables in the form of keys and indexes. Because of the navigational model in DBMS, fetching data is very slow for complex and large amount of data. On the other hand, data fetching is much faster in RDBMS because of the relationship between tables. So, DBMS is used for small applications and RDBMS is used for complex and enterprise application. Data redundancy is very common in DBMS, leading to difficulty in maintaining the data. In RDBMS, keys and indexes are used to avoid redundancy. Some examples of DBMS are DBase, Microsoft Access, LibreOffice Base, and Fox Pro. The popular examples of RDBMS are SQL Server, Oracle, MySQL, MariaDB, and SQLite. With this, I am concluding this session. Hope you got some idea about DBMS and RDBMS and the differences. If you like this video session, do subscribe my channel and share it with your friends. Also join us in social networks like Facebook and Google+. For more technical articles, online tools, calculators and converters, check out my website mytechbits.com. mytechbits.com. See you again with some more interesting technical sessions. Until then, bye-bye.